see everybody here tonight, church, on a Tuesday night. It's good to be in the house of the Lord. And somebody was telling me today, said, you know, we're going to have a lot of cool weather. I said, don't feel too cool right now.
Awesome.
But thank God for this. Amen. Some folks are really loving this.
Amen.
Some folks are really not. Anyhow, we appreciate being in church tonight and want to get in here and have a good service. So, first of all, we want to go to the Lord in prayer. Everybody got a prayer question over here? Brother Howard. Okay. Brother, yes. Anyone else over here? Around on this side? Yes.
Lady I work with, she goes to Sharonville Church.
Yes.
Her husband is really sick, and he's not a Christian.
Anybody else? All right. Always stand and ask the Lord to move in these requests and bless the service tonight. I want Brother Josh Henson, he's going to be preaching for us tonight.
Amen.
Let's pray. Father, we love you tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Be in your house. Pray you move in a mighty way in the service tonight. Pray you just pour out your spirit, Lord, in this place. Lord, I ask your blessing on devotion and preaching every song, every part of the service. Answer each request the Lord was given, and even the ones that wasn't given in the night of the sinner heart, we pray that you move and answer them in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. All right. Our youth pastor, Brother Jarris Dodson, he's out of town. He should be back here Sunday morning, but he's out of town tonight, so usually we have Brother Trent fill in for him anytime he was gone, so I prayed about it. I asked Brother Devin if he would be willing to just take that place Brother Trent was doing and take care of that when he's not here, the youth pastor's not here, and so we're just going to turn the service over to Brother Devin tonight. And let's just give him worship the Lord here in this service tonight.
Well, I'm glad to be in church tonight.
Yeah.
Amen.
It's an honor, a privilege to be able to come to the house of the Lord. It's something I think we take for granted. But I'll tell you, I wake up on Tuesday mornings ready to come to church.
Yeah.
And it's people often, it's a midweek, you know, you got work the next day sometimes, and you've been working all day, you're tired, but you know, here's another chance we have to serve the Lord. Another chance we have to praise Him. You know, we just made it through shutdown 2+ months. Nobody's allowed to come into these walls, and we're here. Well, let's take this chance, because, you know, who knows if it's going to happen again.
Yeah.
You know, they're talking about a second wave coming, and if they shut down again, we're going to be in the same spot, but we're stuck at home, not able to go to church. So, you know, let's take the chance we have now, the opportunity we have tonight to worship the Lord.
Amen.
And we're going to open up, Sister Kennedy has the devotion. We're going to open up and just listen to her and get in her where she does it.
Amen.
And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with thee, thou that's kind of how we are. You know, we're like, why has this happened? Why have things changed? Why did we have those couple months where we just had to sit outside in our cars and have church? But it continues. Let me find my place. Gideon said to him, "Oh, my Lord, if the Lord be with us, why then has all this befallen us? And where be all these miracles which our fathers told of us, saying, did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt?
Yes.
But now the Lord hath forsaken us and delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. And the Lord looked upon him and said, go in this thy might, and thou shalt save Israel from the hand of the Midianites.
Yes.
Have not I sent thee? And he said unto him, O my Lord, wherewith shall I save Israel? Behold, my family is poor in Manasseh, and I am the least of my father's house. And the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with thee, and thou shalt smite the Midianites as one man." You know, see, oftentimes, just as Gideon did, we ask questions. We become comfortable where we are, and when God tells us that he is going to use us or change us, we ask why, and sometimes we refuse to let God change us and make us better. And another example I was thinking of, and I want to talk about, is Esther. Esther's life was full of changes and things that she didn't expect. Esther was taken from the place where she felt most comfortable. And just as we did, we were taken from the place where we felt most comfortable. We were taken from our church. We were stuck outside in our cars. You know, it wasn't what we were used to. And Esther was in a place where she had to spiritually discipline herself on her own. And that's also something we were given the time to pray and read our Bible like we never have before. And that's something I taught myself while I was at home. I would get distracted by doing things in my house that I would go and forsake reading my Bible or praying because I thought I had other things to do. But sometimes God puts those things in our lives to show us that we need to make more time for Him. And Esther, she used the people in her path to help her people who were in distress. And I was thinking, God gave us outlets at our disposal that we could use to help the lost in distress. Have we taken advantage of this change that God has given us? Have we taken advantage of the things that He's let us have to use? And Esther became a leader. She went through a time of change, but allowed God to mold her and use her during those times.
Yes.
In these situations, these people thrive. I also thought about how Joseph went through many difficulties, but allowed the change that God was bringing him to touch him and those he came in contact with. I'm going to read a song. It's kind of wordy, so you guys are just going to have to bear with me, but my fiance introduced me to it, and it's been stuck in my head over and over and over again. But this song is called Clear the Stage, and what I get out of the song is getting rid of anything that is keeping you from God in a personal relationship with Him. And I'm just going to read certain lines of it, but it says, "Clear the stage and set the sound of lights ablaze, if that's the measure you must take to crush the idols. Jerk the pews and all the decorations too, until the congregation spew, then have revival." And I was thinking, you know, jerk the pews and all the decorations too, until the congregation spew, then have revival. You know, that's kind of what we had to do. We weren't in our pews, we were in our cars. Take all the decorations. We weren't in this sanctuary. We were outside. And, you know, until the congregation spewed and had a Bible, we didn't have the amount of people, you know, probably that week. We didn't see everyone who was there. It was different.
Yes.
And another part is, it says, "Take a breath from all the plans that you have made and sit at home alone and wait for God to whisper. Beg Him, please, to open up His mouth and speak. And pray for real upon your knees until they listen." And I was thinking, you know, like I said before, there is things that God has put in our way to show us we need to take time with Him more seriously. We need to take our time with Him, wait for Him to come and talk to us. And another part I wrote down is, it says, but it was talking about to clean your heart and clean things, but quarantine oftentimes we make excuses. Quarantine is a time for me to deep clean my house. And I thought it needs to be a time where we have searched and cleaned our hearts. You know, instead of concentrating on those things. But change is a two-way street. You know, our ministry broken. And, you know, change isn't easy.
Yes.
Change isn't something that we're used to, but don't let your circumstances change you.
Amen.
You know, that's something that I've been thinking about. But it all depends on how you look at it. Esther could have looked at her problems and given in and just said, oh, I'm going to conform with what, you know, what's going on. But don't let change scare you.
Amen.
And are you letting God change you, or are you letting your circumstances change you? Are you letting worry give you anxiety, or are you letting God change your anxious heart to become a worry-free life? And are you letting Satan keep your mind on negative thoughts, or are you letting God change them into positives?
Yeah.
So like I said at the beginning, is God trying to change you during this time of change? We all have room to grow. We all have things that we can change in our lives.
That's
you
right.
You can't change on your own. And also you might say, God, come and change me.
Yes.
But you have to be willing to let him change you. So I hope that helped anyone tonight. But just be willing to let God change you and change your heart during this time of change.
Amen.
Amen. Help us, Lord.
Understand and why the Lord puts us through certain things, but it's because he wants to take us through that.
Yeah.
And like, Lord, why'd you leave me? You know, he's never really left us. He's carrying us through the storm to make us better on the other side. We have to be willing to let the Lord make us and mold us into what he would have us to be. Bring you ahead. So if you want to come or open worship, let's let the Lord have his way tonight. It's not sit back and just listen to our church view and go on the same way. Let's worship the Lord and let's let God have his way tonight.
Glad to be back on Tuesday. Well, actually, I haven't been here on Tuesday, but glad to be with y'all this Tuesday night, and glad to be back to church. And like Brother Devin said, whenever he was opening up, he was talking about how some of us have just come in from a long day of work, and you may be tired, maybe you're exhausted, maybe just being surrounded by the people you're surrounded by has got you feeling whatever you're feeling, but we've come into the house of God tonight, and we've come to set our minds on God, to get what God has for us, and if we don't set our minds on God, we're not going to get what he has for us. If we just think about everything going on around us, I have work tomorrow, I don't know if I got this stuff, my laundry needs to be done tonight, I have to make lunch for work, or whatever it may be. If we focus on those things, we're not going to get exactly what God has for us.
Right.
But if we'll just take this time and focus on God, he'll help us. Let's sing page 92.
I was lost in sin, but Jesus took me in.
Tell me about your God.
offering up. And Brother Grant, you'll pray over the offering.
Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to be in this church house, Lord. Lord, we ask you to bless the offering and bless the giver. Bless the gift. Amen.
Deserve it.
Right.
Deserve it. grace and the mercy that He shows us every day, but for some reason, He chose to give it to me. Lord, oh me, I'm nobody, but God saw something inside of me.
Hallelujah.
Sent His Son down to die for me. Hey, that'll get you excited, I know it will.
That's good.
I don't know much, I'm not a parent, and I can't say I understand it, but I've got, you know, three brothers and a sister, and I couldn't imagine losing one of them for somebody else. And God said, you know what? I love Devin enough.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
say.
Yeah,
Lord.
Brother Devin, I actually got a testimony on the Lord. I know it's youth service.
Yes.
But I challenged myself for a lot of different reasons to start to memorize again, you know, like we did when we were kids, more scripture. And I've been working on Psalms 108. And verse 1 is, "Oh God, my heart is fixed. I will sing and give praise, even with my glory." And so I'm just putting that to memory, but I got to thinking, even with my glory. And I talked to the family about, I'm like, even with my glory, what do you think about that? And I went to another translation that said, "With my whole heart."
Praise God.
Oh God, my heart is fixed.
Yes.
I will sing your praise.
Yes.
Even with my whole heart.
Yes.
I appreciate the Lord. I owe him nothing less but my whole heart.
Hallelujah.
And I
hallelujah.
A Savior in spirit, he had good news to bring. For all with hearts to listen, came a message from the King.
Sorry, hallelujah. I just want to share just a little things that I thank God for. You know,
came. And those are the things that I just thank God for. I thank God for laughter. On my way here, we just laughing up just for ourselves. And that's the thing that God do. Amen. Hallelujah. I know I'm not here on Monday, and we thank God for that. But I thank God that we didn't just laugh at things. On my way to church, I thank God for the small things as well as the big things that happened in our life. And I just have to share that because I want you to laugh too, because laugh what they say is good message. We get it real. That's right. KAN Church, that's Cain. Amen. That's all that he's saying for you.
I feel my praise.
Lord, say.